The dinosaur material we have here at the museum is from the Tendaguru area. This is a remote part of today's Tanzania, and the excavations took place between 1909 and 1913. And they were led by a team here from the museum, the former Paleontological Institute. When the first dinosaur bones came out, nobody thought that it would develop like this and you would find this huge amount of dinosaur bones. So they started going around exploring the area, and in the end they came up with around 37 different places that yielded different dinosaurs. Usually two German researchers stayed there and they guided the African workers and trained them. Usually they just got up in the morning and then started going to the excavation places and excavated specimens, but they labeled them also and numbered them. So it was a very complex, also very hard work for everybody. In the end, they developed like a village structure around the Tendaguru area, where everybody was based with a little shop and medical supplies. Women and children also moved there, and so they lived all together in this village. The big bones of the Giraffe Titan were found already in the beginning of the expeditions, but it took around 2 years until they were able to dig it out completely and until they found the complete skull that is also in the exhibition. And this was a really big surprise because complete dinosaur skulls were very poorly known. All of the bones were slowly dug out and then brought in pieces to Berlin because they were very big and heavy. And it took about 20 years until they could show the complete mound in the dinosaur hall. Okay, so now we have the row of dinosaur bones here that belong to Giraffe Titan. And do you think which one should be chosen?
I was thinking one that we can compare the photogrammetry technology with the Artek scanner.
Yeah.
Maybe this one or this one, because they are almost complete.
Yeah.
For example, check the transverse processes.
Yeah.
And the neural spine. So
yeah, maybe this one is better because it has a more complete neural spine.
Yeah.
So and then let's have a look at this. Okay.
My current research tries to better assess the best techniques for digitalization in the vertebrate paleontology collection of the museum, taking into account the color, size and fragility of the specimen, but also the budget of the researcher, the time in which he needs the specimen, and the final function of the 3D model, like for example, the quality will be not the same if you use it for a finite element analysis, for example, or if you wanted to print it for an exhibition in the museum.
So what are we going to do with this specimen now?
If you want, I can deal with the Artek scanner and you can help me move in the turning table, please.
Yeah, so okay. It's like this.
Yeah, it's almost in the green zone. Okay, I think I got the right distance. Let me check.
So you need to stay always in this distance.
Yeah, so let's start. Already done.
Okay. Yeah, that looks good.
Yeah. I would like to make some guidelines and protocols because a lot of people is now self-teaching how to use these digitalization techniques, but they don't use standard protocols.
Digitization techniques are important also for our collections, just to make the material better accessible. For example, if you have these 3D scans, then you can provide scientists that have some questions, for example, want to reconstruct muscles or want to have a look at the dimensions of bones with these 3D models without making it necessary that they come here. And on the other hand, if we have 3D techniques like CT scanning, then we are able to have a look at the internal structures of the bones without destroying them. And this is very important because we need to keep the specimens for the future. So we just get more information without interacting with the material.
I'm doing photogrammetry with this specimen. It's a kind of the digitalization technique in which you take several photos of the specimen, trying to overlap each one of them. So with all of this data, we can develop later with a post-processing workflow in the computer, the 3D model. If you need your specimen as fast as possible, yes, I would recommend to use the Artec scanner. But in the case you want a really high quality specimen, I prefer to use photogrammetry. You can go closer to the specimen and reconstruct the rugosities or prominences easier than with the Artec scanner.
The Giraffa titan lived about 150 million of years ago, so this is a time we call the late Jurassic, and belongs to a group of dinosaurs which are called sauropods. These are the largest dinosaurs we know. We assume that Giraffa titan lived in herds, so they were social animals that wandered over very long distances along the coasts and just found their food and the backlands and the forests that grew there. And we know that the Tendaguru area, for example, is a lagoonal area where the dinosaurs probably wandered along the coastlines and looked for food at the forests that were nearby. And when some animals died, they were just placed there, and with some storms or tsunamis or some flood events, these cadavers were just flooded into the shallow sea and then deposited there. So we assume that this is an explanation for the richness of dinosaur bones and for the plethora of different dinosaur bones we find there, that the conditions for the preservation of the specimens were very, very good.
After we have made all the photos, thanks to the photogrammetry technique, then we need to upload everyone in the software, and then we end up with a 3D model of the specimen that can be in higher or lower quality. And then with this model, we put our 3D model in the skeleton, so we can later can study, for example, the muscle reconstructions or the other ranges of motion, and later the biomechanics, in this case of Giraffa titan. Research is a thing that is developing each year more and more thanks to new technologies and innovative research. So, museum collections and their preservation are of great importance because we can unravel more mysteries and more information in our case of these fossils thanks to these technologies, like, for example, in this case, digitalization.